Tatra astangamite, before this Mahadadya Prakriti Vikritya Sapta, in fact I was on this line, and it's a very important line, one sentence, Tatra astangamite visheshanam, where the effects lose their peculiar features, their features which are peculiar to them as effects, like, right, nivritta parinama vyaparanam, where they lose their function, which are peculiar to them. Nivritta means lost. Vanished, nivritta, gone, nivritta. Parinama vyaparana, their functions as parinamas, as effects. See, it's a simple thing. See, I tell you, like for example, take into consideration and the scientific fact that there is electricity, there is energy. Now, this energy is reflected both in the tube light and in the fan. Like, same energy, same something, but performing two different things. One gives air, another gives light. All right? Because the two instruments are different. One is of a certain structure, tube light is of a certain structure. Tomorrow again their structures can change, but their structures will remain different. Right? Tomorrow again human beings may come into being, but their shapes and forms will be different. This body will not be, this body will not be born again, though this soul can be born again, acquire a new, or rather a new and a different body, right? So similarly, everything has a particular quality which is specific to it. There's a law which the Nyaya Vaisheshika is acquainted with. Nitya Dravya and Vishesha. Nitya Dravya and Vishesha. Nyaya theory is that, just a moment, that any two things are different. For example, just a moment, doesn't matter. For example, if you take the example of two pots, see, there is also a Nyaya Vaisheshika Niyam and there is also a Leibnizian law, the identity of indiscernible. Have you heard of that? Identity of indiscernibles. I'll explain this. Then you will be able to understand this. What I am trying to say, and what Yuktidipika is trying to say, that any two things in the world, whether of the same category or of a different category. For example, human beings belong to one category, humanity, man. Animals belong to one category, animal, right? Material objects belong to one category, material object. Fan may belong to the category of fan among material objects, and yet any two fans are different. Even if they are produced by the same machine or by the same industry, any two fans are different. Any two things are different, though they may also be similar in some respect. I would say, this table is like me. You would wonder how. I would even say, this table is like all of you. How? Has anybody an explanation? No, not necessarily. You are assuming that I am only made up of matter. Yes, it exists. Very good. It exists. I also exist. Satta samanya. Nyaya vaishaji. Existentness. Existence. Existence is a predicate which can be predicated of any existent thing. I would say, you exist, I exist, table, fence, and what not. So many things exist. So they are all alike, they are all similar in one character or another character. And besides, I can think, if I am a body, and therefore a physical thing, I am like other physical things, I have spatial dimensions. I am tall, I have breadth, and so on. I have height, breadth, etc. Like this fan. Isn't it? Meri lambai hai, chodai hai, vagaira. But can I say that my sadness is so much high, so much tall, or so much broad? Can I say that? That my agony over my dead wife is so much deep, as for example, the well is very deep. We say a well is 20 feet deep. Can I say that my grief is 20 meter deep or more deep? It can be more deep than it was earlier. It was yesterday. Or it was less deep than it was yesterday. Sorry, it was less deep. It may be less deep than it was yesterday. Time passes. And time heals up the wounds. Okay. But my mental state, my conscious states do not have spatial dimensions. They are not long or broad or high, tall. Anyway, so what I mean is that any two things, even of the same class, are different from each other. Right? Even two all pins are different from each other. I keep two pins here. One is to my left, another is to my right. And if I am not there, then one pin is on the right side, another pin is on the left side. Isn't it? So they are different. Their qualities are different. Right? So, Leibniz says, any two things of the world, however similar, like Nyaya Vaisheshika, any two atoms of the world, however similar, since they are both atoms, they must be different in some respect or not. But atoms have no parts. So, Nyaya Vaisheshika insists that something can differ from another thing only in terms of parts, and atoms have no parts. So how do the atoms differ? He says self-differentiated, svato-vyavritta. Nyaya Vaisheshika could not find a very valid reply, but anyway, recognized that there was a difficulty, so it says self-differentiated. But two atoms, कोई दो अणु एक दूसरे से अलग हो सकते हैं क्योंकि अगर if any two things are not different, if they combine, they cannot produce a third different thing. If any two things are absolutely similar, in all 100% similar, if they combine, they cannot produce a third dissimilar things. You keep on pouring water into water. What will it produce? Pouring water into water. What will it produce? You keep on pouring milk into milk. What will it produce? But you put into a small curled element, a curd element into milk, curd element, and it will be transformed into dahi or curd. Isn't it? So some dissimilarity is always there. That is the point which is being emphasized here. Nivritta parinama vyaparada. Anga angi bhava anupagachata. And when these three gunas, sattva, rajas and tamas, are not in a state of being predominant and subservient to each other, when no guna dominates another two gunas, and no two other gunas remain subservient to a third guna, what is called by Sankhya Sutras, Samyavastha Prakriti, Samyavastha, where there is no dominance by one guna over another. Upasangrita Shakti Nam, where their power, their ability to produce something like mahat or ahankar, etc., is withdrawn, upasangrita, has been taken away. Sarva vikara samyam, where there is a balance of all the vikaras, of all the effects. See, the simple illustration here is dreamlessly, I again come back to dreamlessly, all the vikaras, isn't it? I'm in a state of equipoise. Nothing agitates me in dreamless sleep. No drum disturbs me, nothing disturbs me. All the vikaras, modifications of the mind, chitta vrittiya, chitta vritti, mental state, they are all gone. Mental states, different mental states do not exist. There is simply a state of equipoise. I am simply asleep. Sarva vikara samya. Right? Sarva shakti pralaya. Against, with a different emphasis, sarva shakti pralaya. All the powers are gone. Powers of what? Powers to produce. Sarva shakti pralaya. Pralaya means dissolution. Dissolution. Absorption. Absorption. Pralaya. That is why I say pralaya. The whole cosmos is dissolved into its seed. Sari jo samashti hai, sara jo vishwa hai, wo apne beej mein samahit ho jata hai. Dissolution. Pralaya. Praleen ho jata hai. Praleen. Praleeyante asmriti pralaya. ठीक है ना जय, खत्म हो जाता है. निसत्ता सत्ता, निसत्ता सत्ता, इट कैन नीदर बी कॉल्ड एग्जिस्टेंट नॉर नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट. निसत्ता सत्ता, दैट इज डिवॉइड ऑफ सत एंड असत, सत्ता एंड असत्ता. Why? This is very important. Because prakriti, the unmanifest prakriti, in which all these things dissolve, losing their peculiarities, those peculiarities which distinguish them one from the other, which distinguish them from one another, right? When they are lost, that prakriti cannot be known. And if it cannot be known, it is almost non-existent. Nyayvasheshik said, yadeva sat tat prameya. Tat prameya. Whatever exists can be known. He doesn't say pramita. He doesn't say gyata. He says it can be known. Nyaya Vaisheshik doesn't say whatever exists is known. Then God, if God exists, God is known to everybody. Phir to Ishwar ka anuman karne ki zarurat nahi hai. And if My kidney exists, it must be known to me. It must be known even to the child who has the kidney. Kidney ka size kya? Mujhe to aaj tak nahi pata meri kidney ka size kya. But kidney can be known. It exists. Satta hai na kidney ka. Isliye usko jana ja sakta hai. Isliye wo gyan ka vishay ban sakta hai. And if it is a possible object of knowledge, it is a potential object of knowledge. It can always be known. लेकिन जो प्रकृति है, जो साम्यावस्था है, जो सूक्ष्म से सूक्ष्म है, उसकी सत्ता तो है, लेकिन उसकी सत्ता तो भगवान महर्षि कपिल को भी जानी नहीं जा सकती। तो ऐसे है जैसे कि उसकी सत्ता नहीं है। जिसकी सत्ता हो लेकिन जिसको जाना ना जा सके, इट इज इक्विवेलेंट टू नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट एंड येट इट एग्जिस्ट बिकॉज इफ इट डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट इट कैन नॉट गिव राइज टू द वर्ल्ड इट कैन नॉट प्रोड्यूस द मैनिफेस्ट वर्ल्ड इट कैन नॉट प्रोड्यूस महत इट कैन नॉट प्रोड्यूस अहंकार फ्रॉम मनत That is, there can be no evolution if it doesn't exist. The world does not comes out of nothing, does not come out of nothing. If any scientist says that the world has come out of nothing, I disagree with him. If something comes into being, it always comes into being from something. Complete absence of anything cannot produce anything, cannot produce something. Shunyata jo hai, shunyata not of Nagarjuna, no, shunyata, absence of everything, complete absence. Abhav jo hai, usse bhav paida nahi ho sakta. Aisa Gita mein bhi aaya, I don't remember the specific lines now because I have not studied Gita for a long time. Na sato jayate, something like that. What is that? Na sato vidyate bhavo. Na sato vidyate bhavo. Yes, something like that. So Gita agrees with Sankhya Yoga. Gita agrees. Gita accepts the teaching of Sankhya Yoga in many respects. I am not saying Gita preaches Sankhya. It's very difficult to say what Gita actually preaches. It preaches all those things which different commentators say it preaches. Ramanuj says one thing, Shankar says one thing and so on. Vinoba Bhave says something else. And Lokmanya Tilak, the great Lokmanya Tilak, Bal Gangadhar Tilak says something else. Sri Aurobindo says something else. So all these different commentators have interpreted Gita in their different way. So it is very difficult. If I give any view about what Gita preaches, it would be yet another view. So I won't say anything. Nissatta satta. Nissat asat. Avyakta lakshanam avasthantaram upasampraptana. Avyakta lakshanam. It acquires the state, it acquires the character of avyakta, unmanifest, avasthantaram, and this unmanifest state, whose unmanifest state? Of the effects. Effects return back to their unmanifest state, to their potential state. Prakriti is always like that. But effects, leaving their character as effects, return to their seat. Right? That is called prakriti. And then he says, pradhana lakshanam avasthantaram karyam syat. This is the meaning of karya. Meaning of effect is, which after losing their specific characters, so and so forth, go back to their seat bed. Right? Which can neither be called existent nor non-existent. Which means, if something is to be called called, not to be. Something can be real without being known. But if something exists and has to be known, it has to be manifest. What is unmanifest cannot be known. What is unmanifest? Jo abhivyakt nahi hai, jo abhivyakti ko prapt nahi karta, uska gyan nahi ho sakta. Jo mere man mein jo geet hai, a poem which has not been written cannot be enjoyed. Isn't it? A poem which has not been written or which has not been uttered cannot be enjoyed. A song which has not been composed cannot be sung. So it has to acquire a manifest form. But some people draw from this conclusion that only the karan exists. Karyas are nothing but modifications of the cause. I do not accept that view. That is the view, for example, of Advaita Vedanta. But I would say humbly that karya, Sankhya Yoga says that the effect, that the vikar is as real as the cause. I cannot say my parents are more real than me. I am as real as my parents. I am a different person from my parents, though I am born of them and have some of their qualities. I may be tall like my mother. I may be loud speaking like my mother, unlike my soft speaking father. But I may have the appearance of my father. And yet I may be different from them both. Indiscernibility of identicals, identity of indiscernibles. Everything must differ from another thing in some respect or another. No two things can be absolutely identical. Even the twins can't be identical. Because of the twins, one comes into being at one time, another comes into being at another time. So one may be older, another may be younger. So there's a temporal difference. And who knows, their appearance too may be somewhat different. I have seen twins, one is dark, one is fair. Because one of the parents is dark, another is fair.
There are biracial twins also.
Yes?
Biracial twins.
Huh? Yes.
And the other
maybe in the appear proper. Yes. Very sure. Why not?
And you won't be able to get it. They are siblings.
Yes. No. Just to illustrate, my example may be wrong. It doesn't mean that the theory I am advocating is wrong. My example may be wrong, but the Sankhya theory, on which I am trying to communicate with you, may be right. See? Nibritta parinama vyaparana. As effects, they are different. Okay. Now, mahadadya na prakriti vikriti we have done. Shodashakastu vikaro na prakriti na vikriti purushaha. Then we move a little further. Now comes, after some pages, a line which I have already invited your attention to. Uchyate, firstly there is a query. Na tarri idam pratipattavyam shodashako vikara eviti. He says, that why it should be the case that these Shodashakas, Ekadash Indriyas, 11 organs, along with Manas, 5 senses, 5 organs of sense, cognitive senses, 5 organs of 5 motor organs, and 1 Manas. Why these 11 and 5 Panchabhabhutas, they should only be Vikaras, and they should not produce anything else? Then the answer is, the query is put in these words, Ah, na tarri idam pratipattavyam shodashako vikara eveti. Uchyate pratipattavyam. It should be accepted. That these 16 entities, padarthas, are only vikaras. Why? King karanam. Kya karan hai? That they should be accepted only as effects or as modifications. Tattvantar anupapatte. Because another tattva, another tattvantar parinam, as I said, another tattva is inconceivable. Kisi aur tattva ki kalpana nahi ki ja sakti. Aisa nahi ki ho nahi sakta. But so far as our imagination goes, so far as our intellectual ability goes, we are unable to conceive of any further tattva. We can conceive of other objects which are made up of these tattvas, but not of a 24th evolute. 23 evolutes are there, 24th evolute or 25th evolute or tattva. Tattvantara anupapatte. Iha purushartena henute hetuna samyat prachutanam gunayam yoyam mahadadi visheshanto viparinama sat tattvantarotpatti niyamena vyavatishthate. All this vyakta jagat, leaving aside purush, this follows only one law, that one tattva comes out of another tattva. But there are tattvas from which no other tattva comes into being. This is the meaning of this. Natu prithivyadibhya tattvantarotpatti asti. Artha, etc. Artha is a mahabhut. Prithvi is a mahabhut. So prithvi as a mahabhut does not produce any other tattva. Now you may say, but a pot is born, pot is produced of prithvi. You may say, pot also has smell. He may say, yes, pot has smell because of the earth. Pot is not a separate tattva. It may be an object. It's not a tattva. You understand? As she said, the basic categories, the building blocks, that's the right word, building blocks, like bricks. Eete jo hai, they are the building blocks of the whole building. Right? Kahin aap marble laga dete hain, kahin aap lakdi laga dete hain, kahin aap eet laga dete hain, bricks laga dete hain, and then a building is erected. So different type of things. Are you following, gentlemen? Huh? Yes or no? Please tell me. Be sure. Okay, thank you. Natu prithivyadibhya tattvantarotpatti asti. Prithvi, etc. Adi means prithvi, ap, tej, dejas, vayu, akash. These gross elements do not produce any other tattva. Tasmat etesham vikaratvam eviti. Therefore, they are only vikaras. They are only karyas. And karyas means effects. Effects. They are only parinamas. They are only consequences. In life it happens that one action gives rise to a parinama, a consequence. That consequence may lead to another consequence. For example, suppose a person may fail in a secondary examination, a boy or girl. This has happened, right? Now this may occasion depression in the mind of the person concerned. One consequent. Depression may result either into further depression, right? Or a defeatist attitude with regard to oneself, or a fourth consequence, suicide, or an attempt at suicide. One consequence after another. But these vikaras do not lead to any further consequence, that is any tattva. There may be a chain of consequences, there may not be a chain of consequences. Somewhere the list of consequences, series of consequences may stop. So after suicide, what? Nothing follows. There is only grief, but that is with respect to other people. That is in the minds of other people. Right? Like that. So now we move further. Now we come to line Aha. Then there follows 3-4 more lines which express the same idea somewhat in different language through different examples. I'm skipping that and I'm coming to Purush. Aha, he asks, now a query, it's not the opponent, but a query. A query also can be represented by the expression Aha. Somebody asks, Purushetarnika Pratipatti. Why do you accept Purush? Purushetarnika Pratipatti. Why do you accept Purush as a 25th category? He says, there are things which are neither causes nor effects. Suppose that God is there. Suppose, instead of Prakriti, suppose that God exists. And if God is a creator, has God been created by somebody? But God is the creator, is the cause of everything. In Him we live and move and have our being. But God is not an effect. God is a cause. But sometimes God may not be the cause. For example, in Nyaya Vaisheshi, it is only a nimitta karana. What is nimitta karana? Nothing. I am not asking you to give the definition of nimitta karana. No. The real agent causes are the anus, are the paramanus. Are the paramanus. Samavai karana of the world are paramanus, anus. They are the cause. Purusho nahi ayam avasthantaram. And then he says, uchyate na prakriti na vikriti purusha. Purusho nahi ayam avasthantaram pratipadyate. Kata, a self, purush, never changes into another state. Have you found this? Nahi avasthantaram pratipadyate, no khalopi avasthantarasya avasthantaram bhavatiti. Says, Purush does not enter into any other state. And Purush is not a consequence of any other state. Purush does not enter into any other state and is not a consequence of any other state, like suicide is a consequence of the state of depression. And depression is a state, depression is a consequence of failure in the secondary examination. Right? So Purush, that means Purush does not change. This is a highly this is a highly problematic hypothesis that Purush doesn't change. Because the idea behind is that since Purush is eternal, it should not change. Somehow, this idea has pervaded the philosophies of Sankhya, Yoga, and Advaita Vedanta, and even some of the other Vedantas, but not necessarily the Vedantas of Ramanuj or Madhva or Nimbark. But Nyaya Vaisheshik accepts that Purush can change, self can change. Raga, Ichha, Raga, Dvesha, Prayatra, etc. Nyaya Sutra says, a Purush can desire, a self can desire. But the Sankhya, Yoga and Advaita Vedanta self cannot desire. It cannot desire ekoham bahusyam. But the Upanishad says ekoham bahusyam. I am alone, let me be many. But how can self, which is immutable, how can it will, how can it desire? आत्मा को इच्छा कैसे हो सकती है जब आत्मा में कोई विकार ही नहीं पैदा होता. इच्छा तो विकार है ना, इच्छा होना तो विकार है ना. मेरी इच्छा है मुझे अभी ठंडा रसगुल्ला मिल जाए, इच्छा है, मन में विकार है. विकार का मतलब समथिंग हैज कम इन टू बीइंग, समथिंग हैज एरिजन इन माई माइंड. मैं इच्छा करता हूं है? अच्छी सी नींद आ जाए, इच्छा है. लेकिन क्या ईश्वर सोच सकता है कि मुझे अच्छी नींद आ जाए? अगर ईश्वर ये सोच सकता है कि मुझे अच्छी नींद आ जाए, लेट मी स्लीप वेल एटलीस्ट दिस नाइट, इफ नॉट सो मेनी बिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स, व्हेन आई हैव बीन एक्टिव सस्टेनिंग द वर्ल्ड, लेट मी स्लीप नाउ लाइक विष्णु स्लीप्स, शेषनाग sleeps for billions of years. Let me have a sleep. Too tiring a job looking after the world. Too tiring a job. So the point is, what is the meaning of these Upanishadic statements? If God can't will, if God can't desire. But if God desires and God is self, God is self. In Vedanta, Sankhya and Yoga, in Yoga also, Vishesha Purusha. Vishishta Purusha is God. Is Purush, but Vishishta Purusha. Sankhya, of course, does not accept God. So let us exclude Sankhya. Neither Yuktidipika nor Sankhyakarika, the original car. But Advaita Vedanta accepts God in some form, but rejects that God can will. God doesn't have a desire. If it has a desire, it will become a finite being. Hamari tarah ho jayega. Iska matlab wo incomplete hai. Kyunki koi ichha karne ka matlab ye hai ki koi cheez mujhe mili nahi hai. To desire something means that I want to have something which I earlier did not have. So how can it happen with respect to God? That God did not have anything with it, and now it desires itself to have that thing. Then again, we say, God is sarvajna, sarvavit. Don't we say that? God is omniscient. Do we say that or not? Satyam jnanam anantam brahma. Jnanam, complete knowledge. It is also all-powerful, omnipotent. Sarva Shaktiman, isn't it? Sarva Shaktiman. Okay, if God is Sarva Shaktiman, can God commit suicide? Or can God, as the example I find in Western philosophy, can God build a stone which will destroy itself? No? So God is also bound by its laws, its nature. God also has a certain nature. So it's not absolutely correct to say that God has no nature or God is nirguna. God has a certain nature. It is, for example, Satya, Satchidananda. If I say, John is conscious, do I need to add, John also exists? If I say, Rama is conscious, Rama, a lady called Rama, is conscious, is a conscious being. Do I need to add, she also exists? But why does Advaita Vedanta add Satchidanand? It is enough to say Chit. Ananda I can understand. Certain things may exist which don't have Ananda, which are not happy. I may be an unhappy man. Some of you may be unhappy with yourself. Almost everybody is unhappy with himself. Right? So we wish to be happiness. And there may be an entity who is complete bliss. Besides being conscious, besides having consciousness, is complete bliss. But why do we need to add Sat? It also exists. Oh, something is conscious, something is happy, but we need to add a third feature, it also exists. Why? No, Satta does not mean eternal. Is there any definition of existence which implies that to exist means to exist eternally? No. We can say he exists and he exists eternally. Like we say, self exists but is neither a cause nor an effect. And since either it is neither a cause nor an effect, it is eternal. Because what is an effect only gets absorbed into its seat, like Mahadadi, etc. So self is not. Argument is being given. And since Prakriti is a cause, Prakriti is Parinami. Prakriti changes into something else. Prakriti badalti hai kisi cheez mein. Prakriti ki abhivyakti hoti hai. ये जो व्यक्त जगत है ये प्रकृति की अभिव्यक्ति है. द ग्रॉस द मैनिफेस्ट वर्ल्ड इज ए मैनिफेस्टेशन ऑफ प्रकृति. यस है. व्हाई देर आर मैनी पुरुषास, दैट्स अ डिफरेंट क्वेश्चन. देर कैन बी मोर देन one entities which are unchanging. Manyness does not involve change. Yes, if the same thing becomes many, then it is changing. But there can be many things which are unchanging. All purushas are unchanging. You and I can't help it. They are different. Incidentally, humbly, I have discussed this problem in a paper of mine which was published in 2004 with respect to Sankhya itself. Manyness of selves, Purush Bahutva, manyness of selves, Sankhya and K.C. Bhattacharya. It is also a problem with regard to the problem of other minds. You know, there is the problem of other minds. Wittgenstein also discusses this, MacTaggart discusses this, and other people. Hegel discusses it. And in India, in fact, my first published article, I am not saying written article, published article, was on Dharmakirti on the existence of other minds, which was carried in Journal of Indian Philosophy, which is now has been taken over by Springer. and Professor B.K. Mathilal, Bhima Krishna Mathilal, used to be the editor. It was published in 1985. You can see it there. Dharmakirti, the Buddhist philosopher. Santanantar Siddhi. Santana, Chitta Santana. Anya, Santanantar, other. Other consciousness series exist. Dharmakirti tries to prove that other minds exist within his idealist framework and by rejecting the external world. Anyway, so this problem, manyness of selves, this article appeared in 2004 in Philosophy East and West. You can, through Google, you can locate it. I don't remember the issue number, etc. Who says? Purushas are many.
No,
yes, Prakriti is one.
Prakriti is one, but
changing. Eternally changing. Parinami. Nitya Parinami. Eternally changing. What do we do? We are helpless. If it changes, we can't do anything about it. If certain things are unknown to me, are not known to me, what can you do about that? You can't do anything. Sorry, Ramesh Babu. You have to devise some strategy to understand things more fully. Right? Now he says, Aha, again aha, after this. Naitad yuktim antarena shaddhiyate. Hence the significance of the name Yuktidipika. Dika? Natad yuktim antarena shaddhiyate. Tasmat upapadyatam kemasya prakritittvam avikritittvam cha. Questioner. Another query. See, you simply have stated, you simply have uttered a sentence that Prakriti is neither a cause nor an effect. But we can't agree with you unless you produce some argument. There has to be argument. Either I say this glass exists. You say, how do you know? I say, I can see it. And you also can see it if you use your eyesight properly. And don't pretend not to see it. Right? You also can see it. It's a public object, it's a public domain. It's not like my state of happiness, which can't be known easily by other people. Right? So he naitat yuktim antarena shaddhi. We cannot believe you. We cannot trust you. We cannot agree with you that Prakriti is neither a cause nor an effect unless you produce some proper, legitimate, proper argument. You know, a credible argument. Credible argument. Tasmat upapadyatam katham asya prakritittvam avikritittvam cha iti. Therefore, tell us in what consists its prakritittva and its vikritittva. In what sense it is a prakriti and in what sense it is a vikriti? He says, Uchyate. Prakritittva anupapatti. It cannot be a cause. This we will show later. Uttaratra pratividhanat. This we will show later. Where? Tasmacha viparyasat. Karika number 19. Sakshittam asya purushasya. Drashtittam akartrittam, etc. Right? That we will propound later. Ityatra yuktim upadekshama. There we have given our reason. Yuktidipika. A lamp of reasoning. reasoning of the Sankhyakārikā. What is the basic reasoning of the Sankhyakārikā, basic argument of Sankhyakārikā? That is what Yuktidipika takes upon itself to illuminate. Tasmāt tāvat tāvar asya aprakatittam. Therefore, because of that reason, which we have explained in the forthcoming kārikā number 19, because of that reason, we say that Purusha is not prakriti. Purusha is opposite to prakriti. Avikritattvam pradhanavāt. Avikritattvam. Purusha is not prakriti. That we'll explain. But Purusha is also not avikriti. It is like prakriti in that respect. That is why it is said, vyaktam tatha pradhanam, vyaktam tatha pradhanam, vyaktam tatha pradhanam, atad viparitah tatha cha puman. As Professor Penna recited this karika, vyaktam tatha pradhanam, tad viparitas tatha cha puman. All this is vyakta, anityam aviveki vishaya, what is that? Just a moment. Huh? The karika trigunam aviveki vishaya samanyam achetanam prasavada. Trigunam aviveki vishaya samanyam achetanam prasavadharmi. Vyaktam tatha pradhanam. Tad viparita tatha chapuman. There's a common feature between the vyakta world and avyakta prakriti. And Purush is like Prakriti and unlike Prakriti in some respects. So Purush is like Prakriti in what sense? That Purush is not an effect. But Purush is unlike Prakriti in what respect? Prakriti is a cause, but Purush is not a cause. But Purush is also like Prakriti in one more way. Please tell us, who will tell me?
Eternal.
Very fine. Nitya. Both are nityas. Only prakriti is nitya but changing. Parivartan hota rata prakriti mein. Prakriti kuch na kuch paida karti rati hai. Purush nitya hai, kisi cheez ko paida nahi karta. Kisi cheez ko utpanna nahi karta. Lekin nitya dono hai. See, all these are very sukshma distinctions, very subtle distinctions. Sāṅkhya is the foundation of Indian philosophical thought. Sāṅkhya may not be all right in every respect, but it is a very provocative system. It is a very provocative system. It stimulates your mind. If you can spare enough time and spend enough energy on studying this. Avikritattvam pradhanavat. Purush is avikriti, like prakriti. Yatha pradhanam evam ayam api purusha kriyamana karanantarai ishvaradi bhi anarabhyate. Like pradhan, like prakriti, Purush also is not brought into being, is not brought into being by other causes like Ishwar, etc., Ishwar or time, etc. It's not brought into being. Karanantarai, other causes. And Karan world is in Bahuvachan, is in plural. There can be many Karanas. Different systems believe in different Karanas. Like, for example, I gave you the example of St. Thomas. He said that self or soul, which means the same thing in St. Thomas Aquinas, is brought into being by God, is created by God, and attached to and finds its place through the parents. Attached to a body to the parents. So, self is born. Though it knows no end, but it has a beginning. Follow? Kasmat patishedhat, because that we have refuted. Yatha karanantarani nasanti tatha uttaratra patishedha karishyate. Why there are no other causes to self, this we will explain later on. Uttaratra, this we will explain later on. Na purushantarai. Again, one purush cannot produce another purush. Purush means self, not man. Not man, embodied human being, no. Purush means self. Purishete, who resides in the body. Not who is the body, who resides in the body. Consciousness resides in the body. So one purush, one consciousness cannot produce another consciousness. Tell me, can it? Can it? Just think about it. Yes, please. जन्म के संदर्भ में, जन्म के संदर्भ में ये होता है कि दो जो फिजिकल ऑर्गेनिज्म है, माता और पिता, वो फिजिकल ऑर्गेनिज्म के इंटरेक्शन से एक तीसरी बॉडी पैदा होती है, लेकिन उस तीसरी बॉडी की जो आत्मा है वो पैदा नहीं होती. वो आत्मा शरीर को ग्रहण करती है अपने पहले के संस्कारों के आधार पर, पहले के कर्मों के आधार पर. हाँ. उन माँ बाप को चुन लेती है.
लेकिन दो के बाद तीन आ गई
हैं?
वो एक्चुअली वो दूसरा आ गया ना, मतलब वो
नहीं, आप पूछिए बेशक. आई एम विलिंग. यस, पूछिए आप. हाँ पूछिए बेटा, पूछिए आप.
सर ये कह रहे हैं कि मतलब पहले हमारे पास मुंह माता के, वो पहले माता के पास एक, मतलब मदर जो होती ना उसके पास एक कॉन्शियसनेस होती ना, ये
ठीक है? माता के पास कॉन्शियसनेस है. माता एक पुरुष है, एक सेल्फ है, एक सेल्फ है.
अभी जब
पिता दूसरा सेल्फ है.
हाँ वो दूसरा,
वो भी सेल्फ, क्योंकि पुरुष बहुत्वम.
यस सर, यस.
सांख्य बिलीव्स इन इनडेफिनेट नंबर ऑफ सेल्फ. वो दूसरा सेल्फ है, एक और वो सारे इटर्नल हैं.
जी जी.
केवल उनकी बॉडी नश्वर है, वो एक एक बॉडी लेते रहती हैं जब तक वो मुक्त नहीं हो जाते. तो अपने पूर्व कर्मों, एक मिनट, पूर्व कर्मों के आधार पर वो अपने माता पिता के साथ उनका कभी संबंध रहा होता है तो वो संबंध से जो कर्म पैदा होते हैं, राग द्वेष इत्यादि, वो उस माता पिता के माध्यम से जन्म लेता है पुरुष, और उसको माता पिता की देह, उत्पन्न होने वाली देह प्राप्त होती है.
लेकिन सर कॉन्शियसनेस भी तो आती है देह के साथ, कॉन्शियसनेस भी तो आई ना उसके साथ.
हाँ आएगी,
नेक्स्ट बॉडी में आई. वो
कॉन्शियसनेस तो एग्जिस्ट करती है इटर्नली. हाँ. केवल उसका एक देह के साथ एसोसिएशन होना है.
हाँ.
बस. हाँ वो कैसे होता है ये किसी को नहीं पता. वो कैसे होता है मुझे आप बता दीजिए, कि कोई साइंटिस्ट बता दे कि साहब आप भी एटम से बने हैं या इलेक्ट्रॉन से बने हैं, और मैं भी इलेक्ट्रॉन से बनाऊं, सूची भी इलेक्ट्रॉन से बनी और मैं भी इलेक्ट्रॉन से बनाऊं, वो खास कौन से इलेक्ट्रॉन से जिनसे मैं बनाऊं. कैन एनी साइंटिस्ट टेल? हाउ एवर ग्रेट अ नोबेल प्राइज विनर. थोड़ा आगे आओ, थोड़ा आगे आओ बेटा.
ये जो आप बोले ना, जो संतान मींस एक आत्मा वो बॉडी को पकड़ती है तो वो कॉन्शियसनेस आती है, मींस अभी जो उसको समझाए, तो ये है कि बोलते हैं कि परमात्मा से जीव आत्मा आते हैं, तो
परमात्मा को सांख्य योग में मत लाओ.
अच्छा, नहीं नहीं, हम कॉन्शियसनेस की बात बोल रहे हैं तो.
हाँ, इसलिए परमात्मा और जीवात्मा में एक चीज कॉमन है, दोनों आत्मा है.
अच्छा,
छोड़ दो
ये भी कॉन्शियसनेस.
ना उनको मत छोड़ दो, परमात्मा तो आत्मा है, वो तो न्याय में है. आत्मा द्विविद, आत्मा द्विविदम, जीवात्मन परमात्मन च. देयर इज नो जीवात्मन एंड परमात्मन. सम पीपल यूज द वर्ड जीवात्मन फॉर पुरुष, दैट इज रॉन्ग. you can loosely say it is jivatman. It is self, atman. Okay. So jivatman. Yes. Peace? Yes? Yes? Peace continues. There's no Paramatma. There's no Paramatma in Sankhya. There's no Paramatma in Mimamsa. That is why the English intellectuals, English academic orientalists, when they started studying Indian philosophy, they were very baffled by the Hindu race. What sort of people they are? Everybody believes in God, and yet their philosophical system, some of their philosophical systems are atheist. Sankhya is atheist. And yoga is theist in a very peculiar way. In yoga, God can only have an object of meditation. It can't create the world. So what's of a God of vision? Why not do away with this God? Why do we need this God? I can meditate on myself. I can meditate on myself, on my own heart, on my own eyes. Isn't it? Why should I meditate on some vishesh purusha? Purusha vashishta. As kaha gaya, what is that line? Anklesha karmi vipaka shai aparamrishta purush vashesha Īśvara. Klesha karma vipakashay aparamrishta purush vishesha Īśvara. Vishesha purush. Oh, baad mein bataunga. Phir bahut lamba ho jayega. Kal bataunga. So, God is not a creator. And what is the status of God in Vedanta, by the way? Advaita Vedanta. Oh, mayo pahita Īśvara. He creates the world and yet he doesn't create it. It appears to us that he has created the world, and yet there is no world. Please don't mind my saying so. I'm not indulging in loose talk about any great philosophical system of India. I respect all philosophical thought. They were all great men, and yet their system sometimes may suffer in explanatory adequacy. They may fail to explain certain phenomena. Right? See, if nothing gets born, this applies to Sankhya Yoga also and to Advaita Vedanta. If it is only buddhi which gets bound or released, then what is the purpose that prakriti serve? Bhoga and apavarg of purush. If buddhi buddhi experiences, buddhi gets bound, buddhi gets released, then what is the purush doing?
He's a catalyst.
Yes, he's a catalyst. Very good term. He's a catalyst. But his association is necessary. His association is necessary. Sannidhana. Sanyoga means Vachaspati and Yuktidipika both says. And Vachaspati in fact borrowed the word Sannidhana from Yuktidipika in his Tattva Kaumudi, Vachaspati Tattva Kaumudi. Sannidhana was a very peculiar kind of Sannidhana. Shastriya Sanyoga, as we will see, Yuktidipika words the word Shastriya Sanyoga. What is Shastriya Sanyoga? Shastriya Sanyoga is Prakriti has a purposiveness about it. Prakriti, this creation has a meaning. What is that meaning? To realize the two ends, two arthas, two purusharthas. Give enjoyment to the self and release him from the ensnaring world, from the binding world. Purusharthas. There are very few philosophies. For example, Darwin's evolutionary theory, it is all based on contingency. The world just involves. It has no purpose behind. Srishti ka koi purpose nahi hai. Just evolves. We attach meaning to it. Okay, fine. Hum samajhte hain ki ye aadmi hamare liye bada important hai. Ye mahila bahut important hai. Theek hai na? Ye vidwan bahut important hai. We give meaning to things. There is no meaning in creation. Leela Vattu Kaivalya, Brahma Sutra. हमको इतना सफरिंग होता है और ब्राह्मण का लीला है, इज अ स्पोर्ट फॉर ब्राह्मण. स एकाकी आसीत, अगेन उपनिषदिक स्टेटमेंट. स एकाकी आसीत, ही वॉज अलोन. ए लोनली मैन इज रेस्टलेस. स एकाकी आसीत, एकाकी न रमते. ए पर्सन हु इज अलोन कैन नॉट प्ले, ही हैज टू क्रिएट समथिंग, ईदर ए टॉय और समबडी लाइक हिम. Like him, not absolutely like him, but somewhat like him. Ekaki na ramate. So ekaki asit, ekaki na ramate. So dvitiyam aichat. He wanted a second thing. So he created a bobat with whom to play. So dvitiyam aichat. This is Upanishads. What do various acharyas have to say about it? They will say it's a metaphorical statement. So if this is a metaphorical statement, why not take other statement also as metaphorical? Like they say, neha na nasti kinchana. Often Advaita Vedanta says, neha na nasti kinchana. The world of plurality, jo bahulata ka world hai, bahulata, jahan cheeze alag alag hai aur bahut sari hai, ये वर्ल्ड एग्जिस्ट नहीं करता. द वर्ल्ड ऑफ चेंज एंड बिकमिंग इज अनरियल. नेह नानास्ति किंचित, नाना नानात्व, मैनीनेस, प्लुरैलिटी ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट इज अनरियल. नथिंग इज प्लूरल, नथिंग इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईच अदर, बिकॉज देर इज नो वन थिंग, देर इज ओनली, देर इज, देर आर नो टू थिंग्स, देर इज ओनली वन थिंग, ब्रह्मन और परमात्मन और आत्मन. Fine. No, I salute people who constructed such a philosophy. But there can be disagreements. There can be polite disagreements. Sankhya says, I disagree. He says, Vedanta nam, Vedanta atmaikatvat. Vedanta believe, by Vedanta Yuktidipika means the Upanishads. Not Shankaracharya, because Yuktidipika came before Shankaracharya. Not Shankaracharya. So, Atmaikatva, there is only one Atma. But we say, Purusha Bahuttvam Siddham. Right? To that we'll come later. Now it's already 6:15. I think we should stop here and you will forgive me.